This spot's got a lot of problems, and Marvel is betting perhaps a little too heavily on girl power, to the point they might be pushing away their male audience. But I gotta say, as a member of the female audience, they're starting to really get me. I'm like, yeah, girl power, let's go, I'm so excited. I mean, I've tried to get into Captain Marvel comics. They keep trying to relaunch the title with new number ones and new writers, and they always do a pretty good job at the start, but then it always kind of loses momentum, loses its way, and you're like, yeah, those characters, like, meh. The best I liked it, actually, interestingly enough, was when the Agent Carter TV people, two women worked on the comic. I thought they did a really nice job with it when she was in charge of Alpha Flight as the first line of defense of Earth in space, basically. Kind of like Justice League Watchtower, basically. That was my favorite version of the character recently, and I see shades of that here. She also seems so overpowered. I don't know how the rest of the Marvel Avengers are going to work with her, because it's like, she's like Superman. You know, it's like, everyone else is like, what should we do? And she's like, I have ideas. She certainly seems like a type A personality, which I can relate to. All right, so let's break this down. We start out, I really like this, by the way. Now, I don't like that you have, this is Maria Rambeau, her she's the mother of Monica Rambeau, who's going to be, of course, Captain, you know, well, Photon, and her call signal is Photon in the movie. But, you know, since this is the 90s, it's like they're setting up that character for the future. But I don't like the fact that she says, let's show these boys how it's done. I'm like, do you not want to get along with the other pilots? Like, why do you have to be that way? Just earn their respect with your sweet moves. And they have sweet moves. So I don't see any need to do that. But I have to say, I do think that Brie Larson delivers this line excellently. I don't like the quality of her voice. I think it seems unusual, like it's too affected. Again, as I said from my reaction, it doesn't seem natural to me, but I think her delivery is excellent when she says, higher, further, faster, baby. Rocking the aviators, no less, in that uniform, it's really cool. I mean, it took me a couple of listens to like totally understand their conversation, but I liked it. I liked what was going on. I was like, yeah, let's just, we're so cool, let's just invite the boys to play with us. So here you can see some kind of, it's either an experimental military jet or some alien aircraft they've commandeered. I think this is the one that she and Fury are in. You've seen it in the special look where he's like, can you fly this or not? As you can see, she can. So they're taken off from some kind of secret military base. Now, the theme, obviously, as we've discussed before, is just because you fall down is okay as long as you get back up. But one of you recently wrote, how many times is she going to fall down? That's pretty hilarious. I think at a certain point you'd be like, Carol Danvers, you do fall down an awful lot. Can you try to maybe, like, cut it down a little bit? Because, I mean, like, I don't know. I think it's a good message, but if you're falling down too much, then it's kind of on you. But she's getting back up. Now, I love this shot. This shot is so cool. And again, this is to Brie Larson's credit. She really looks like she knows what she's doing in the cockpit. She looks like she's really in control, but yet still, she's also in danger. She's you know, under fire, and this is a tense situation. You know, she has to get out of it. So I like it. I like that she's not a Mary Sue, but, you know, like she's like, I got this. But, you know, she is a professional. She does know what she's doing. So in just a quick shot, it's really sold me her as a pilot. Now you can see she's being chased by what looks to me, because of the green, maybe, I can't tell Skrull and Kree ships apart at this point, but you'll see it in this next shot in just a second. See, I think that's two different ships. All right, so the blue energy is what turns her Kree, so I would guess that this is a Kree ship with a Skrull chasing it. Now, I believe that's Yon Rogg, and then I think behind him is probably Ben Mendelsohn's character, who knows about her past, and he's like, I was there when you were born, you know, that whole thing. So there's an aerial battle over Earth between two aliens, and she is going to find herself in the middle of it. Good setup. Again, I don't like having the men versus the women. It's not necessary. Wonder Woman didn't do that. I think one of Wonder Woman's strengths was that everybody was together. And so I don't like that these guys are like, who's this hot pilot? She's got everything. You know, I think we've kind of moved beyond that. I mean, this was stuff that they were promoting with G.I. Jane, with Demi Moore, like a long time ago. I think that we're now at the point where we want everyone just to be equals and get along. So I'm not a fan of this shot at all, even though she does look cool. So a lot of flippity-flop. I don't understand the need for flippity-flop in fighting. I mean, I guess it gives you momentum, but I'd be like, you seem like you're exerting too... If anyone knows fighting, please tell us down below. But it would seem like you're exerting a lot of energy that is not going into hitting your opponent. So that, to me, seems a little bizarre. And you can see Yon Rogg took her down. So we have this cool chant over this, which I think is great. I love it. Higher, further, faster. I'm like, I'm totally buying it. And you can see her as a kid, her Judy Hopps moment. Totally out of Zootopia, in my opinion. Now, I like this shot. We've seen this before. I feel like these two members of the Kree Special Forces team on the right are like, I didn't know we were supposed to bring our glowy weapons today. How embarrassing. Or their other thought is, you chumps, please draw all the fire away from us while we stay in the shadows. I also think... I hope that Nick Fury has a big role, but boy, do they spend a lot of money to de-age him. But I think very effectively. So I like this shot too. I like the shot of her mask going on. I'm not quite sure where she is, if she's in space or underwater, but I love the mask. I think it's a little bit not good in terms of VFX, but I just think it's such a cool idea that I'm like, well, I'll go along with it. And I do like blue light, as you know. So there she is. We've seen that shot before. Like, look at it. Okay, so we'll talk about that in a second. But yeah, you can see they're in that ship, and Nick Fury's like, woohoo, this is a great ride. She's like, yeah, I like that moment. She's like, try and keep up. And I'm like, yeah, I kind of like it. But again, you know, I don't think it's a good idea when, you know, women are like, I'm better than everyone else. I think it's important, again, to be a part of the team. Although I do like that smoky eye she's rocking there. Looks good, Brie. All right, so then this is a great shot. So you can see, I guess someone else is flying that plane now. Oh, that plane's retreating. Oh, that's so cool. So that plane's retreating and she's like, I'll take care of it. I love this shot as she pulls back to punch. That's really, really cool. She's so ridiculously overpowered. It's nuts. All right, Thor's like, I'm just gonna go home. So look, she takes out this ship. She just totally takes it out. You know, Superman at least would try and catch the thing and put it down and be like, what do you think you're doing? Let's talk about it. I'm like, I hope that person has a parachute. And she's like, if they don't, it's not on me. Still a standard military procedure. You should take care of your soldiers. But yeah, look at that. She's just like, woohoo, I've killed another one. That's crazy. Total disregard for life. Maybe that could be a conversation in her next movie. I would love that. I love Dark Superman, as you know. So I gotta tell you, as I said, I don't like splitting male and female audiences, but as a female audience member, I'm really drinking the Kool-Aid. So what do you think of this spot? You know, which side are you on? Is this pulling you in or is it pushing you away? Share your thoughts down below. Thanks for going over this with me, and you can check out some more episodes right now.